Hi, look what I have here. Hey, I just wanted to welcome you all to the Gina's bridal shower. We all know how nervous Gina gets when she's the center of attention, so we kind of had this idea to have you guys be the center of attention. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this.
Whenever Nini was first born, what was your first thoughts?
She was the most beautiful baby I have ever seen, and I went into the room to see her, and only family members were allowed. They threw me out, but not before I held her.
All right, Dolly Mama, how long have you known our little Nini?
Oh, I've known little Nini a long time. I'm trying to think. I used to ref her. I ref her probably before I knew her.
How long have you known Mike?
Now, my kids played with Mike. They played him with soccer, and I used to call him Chemo because he always had the bald head. So he was the goalie, so we always called him Chemo. So I've known Mike a long time.
Okay, so if you guys were to guess, where do you think Gina and Mike first met?
I would guess at one of the Shaler schools. And no. If that's wrong, then
no, that's definitely wrong, Nick.
Wasn't Shaler.
Oh.
They clearly... They met in a bocce tournament.
Oh, yeah, that's probably more realistic.
Were they partners, or were they against each other in a competitive nature?
Even if they were partners, they were against each other in a competitive nature.
And who do you think would have been a better bocce player, Gina or Mike?
I think the bird's a great athlete.
The funniest memory you have of Gina?
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's kind of embarrassing. Well, on an away trip, the boys and girls team went to Altoona or somewhere out east, and we stopped at a buffet to eat dinner, and only the female coaches, Gina and I, got really, really sick, something along the lines of Montezuma's Revenge, and it was the night of the Super Bowl, and her and I were texting each other in the bathroom, trying to get updates on the game, but we couldn't go anywhere because of that country buffet.
Okay, so how long have you guys known Nini?
Oh my goodness. Since I was probably 19 years old.
You met Gina when you were 19?
I met her when I moved here, yep.
Wait, not
and Beth?
Teresa,
no,
Gina.
Couldn't have been. Gina.
Gina's only
What? I don't know, she was a little girl.
That is a miracle of birth, my child.
I think just our times together with our ES class and her life skills, and probably Brina being the cat.
So first question for you, Danelle. Where and when did you first meet Gina? So this one time, I walk into work, 2004, sit down, minding my own business for orientation. Who comes walking in but good old foe? She sits down right next to me because she says that I look cool enough to hang out with. That was, what, 12 years ago? Fast forward, and here we are, celebrating her wedding together.
So, what are your questions
here, Danelle? Wait, so, T-Bert, as you're up there hanging up the happy birthday sign, Gina thinks that we're doing something for Luann. We're sneaking this in. What was your first thought, T-Bird, when you found out that Nini got engaged?
He plays softball, too.
What did you first think whenever you found out Gina and Mike were dating?
I was shocked. I was like, whoa, didn't know that was going on. So, but yeah, it's okay.
And whenever you found out they got engaged, what was your first thought?
Well, I was at my grade school reunion and my phone was blowing up, and I was like, holy hell, everybody knows I'm at this reunion, so who's calling me? So I look at this and look at it, I'm like, oh my god, Michael and Gina got engaged. I was like, shock city.
Whenever you first found out that Gina and Mike had got engaged, what was your first thought?
I don't know, disbelief. That's terrible. I shouldn't say that, huh?
Happens.
Aged pride.
I was so excited. It was a sad day, I remember, and she made it so happy.
When did you know that Gina and Mike were good for each other?
When I saw them making googly eyes up at the ESY last year, that's when I knew they were back on.
Okay, so we all know that Gina is not an emotional person. Can you describe the time whenever Gina asked you to be her maid of honor, which could be kind of sentimental? Well, I knew Gina was up to something for a while. And I kind of guessed that it was going to come, but I had been sick from work a couple of days, which means I was not in Shaler. She kept asking me to stop over her house, but I was sick so I couldn't make it. Finally, after calling off work for a day to maybe even three, she finally texted me a picture of a bottle of a wine and said, "You better say yes or else."
Yeah. Nikki, you just did engagement photos with Gina and Mike.
Yes.
What was your favorite part of doing engagement photos with them?
The best was making them actually have to hold each other's hands.
What, did they seem uncomfortable with that?
No, it looked totally natural.
My
favorite part of her taking the pictures, even though I wasn't there, was when I saw the really cute picture of the heart hands, and I said, exactly how much work did it take to make that perfect heart hands? Did they get that right on the first try? She said she really had to work.
They probably had practiced that at prior, too.
Quite possibly.
Right.
But it
turned out really nice.
They weren't prepared for that.
Okay, let me come back so I can catch you. Okay, so whenever you guys heard that Gina and Mike had got engaged, what was the first thing that came to mind?
Well, my first thought was, Nikki's going to look really fabulous in a new dress she's going to get for Gina's wedding. It was probably going to be really short, like maybe strapless, tight number.
Nick, can you tell us about the kind of bridesmaid's dress you'd like to wear, assuming that you're in the wedding party?
I mean, I'm glad that the priest probably won't be at the reception because he probably won't approve. But he will see it when I do my reading, so I guess either way I'm pretty screwed.
I know you've been practicing how you're going to walk down the aisle.
I'll just tell you that. There will not be compression shorts underneath.
But show us how you plan to walk down the aisle when you do your reading.
Okay, well, it's going to look a little like...
We don't want to give away... We don't want to give any secrets away for the wedding.
There might be a little bit more in there. I mean, my back hurts a little today, so I can't give it.
So a little bit more flair then. When we were wedding dress shopping, what were you doing?
I was actually watching the Pirates, the score of the Pirates on my iPhone, but I had my trusty friend Shar.
Shar, what were you doing while we were dress shopping?
I was taking pictures.
Did you shed any tears?
I did.
Did you think that she looked gorgeous in all the dresses?
She looked beautiful in every dress.
Do you like the one that she picked?
That was my favorite.
That was the favorite one. What do you think about T-Bird watching the pirate game during the wedding dress shopping?
That's my friend T-Bird. That is her.
Who has been the second in command for the last 8 to 10 years?
No, I'm going to that.
Julie Stamp.
Nene getting married. Are you excited for her or are you disappointed that you will no longer have a second in command?
I love Mike Shimoleski. We'll keep him. It's okay.
What's one piece of advice you have for her?
Well, I'm not married, and I don't have a boyfriend. But I like Mike, so he's a keeper. Keep Mike.
Keep Mike. We'll stick with that. What you often help Gina in the classroom with her cooking and baking. What's one piece of advice for her in the kitchen because she's going to have to start to feed her new husband?
Keep up the world famous cake and pasta salad. Keep it up.
If you have one piece of advice for Gina in the kitchen, knowing that she's going to have to go from not cooking at all to start cooking for a husband, what would be your advice?
I think look for easy, quick meals that you can make after work. Like, keep it simple, keep it easy.
Like Frank's Pizza.
Yeah. And ask what he likes.
You seem to be the all-around girl here. Fill in this blank for me. When all else fails, please do blank.
Powdered sugar on it.
Yeah.
Or whipped cream, whatever you like.
Hot sauce.
Yeah.
Nice for the bedroom.
Let's see how much the hot sauce.
Yeah. Gina is best for Mike because.
I don't think I can say that on film. I just think they're good together.
Cause.
She keeps him in line.
Lily, are you going to be in Nene's wedding?
Look up the camera. Yeah.
What are you most excited about for being in the wedding?
Flower girl.
Oh, you're going to be the flower girl. What kind of dress do you think you're going to wear?
Flower girl.
What color do you think your dress will be?
White.
Okay, what do you guys think that Gina means to the Crush Nation?
Nothing. I think she's the one to start all this fan base stuff.
Do you think we should raise the Crush Roger?
Yes, absolutely. Definitely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Raising the flag, Ted! The Crush Rider, right? How many times have you raised it this season, Peg?
Yeah.
Three times!
Three times!
Three!
Do
What other qualities do you think Mike and Gina's children will have?
Skinny legs.
Probably be smart.
Smart. Yeah. You know Gina teaches special ed, right? And Mike teaches phys ed.
Yeah, that's why.
They're smart. How would you pick like chemistry or something?
All right, Michael, what do you think about getting a new brother?
I'm excited, and I can't wait for the big day.
What do you think about your brother-in-law having the same name as you?
I'm fine with that. Yeah, that's never an issue for me.
What do you think about, do you think at Christmas Nini will spend more time with Mike's family or with your family?
I think she'll split it pretty evenly. Probably Christmas Eve with our family and Christmas with Mike's. That'd be my guess.
What are you most excited about for the wedding?
Probably the food. Wedding cake.
The food. Awesome. Minnie's not here today. Is he coming?
Yes. Yes. No, he's on his own picnic. Must.
What did Minnie say about the upcoming wedding?
I don't know.
You think I should interview him separately?
Yeah, I just interviewed him separately.
Okay.
Throwing sparklers in the air there or what? That'd be good
too. Are you guys talking about wedding planning?
About the production of the bridal shower.
The bridal shower.
Party. Yeah.
Okay. Shar, I know you've been waiting for this for a long time. What do you think about Lulu?
I'm thinking about being the first reader.
What do you think?
First name reader. Of Jesus.
He's going to be the first reader.
I'm the first reader.
Oh, are you?
Watch how she's going to walk up to the altar.
This moment isn't all about Nini. This is more about Luann's birthday.
Oh, sorry.
little Always Lulu. Making it about herself. And what are you looking forward most to about the wedding itself?
Everything going smoothly. Because, you know, like you're all nervous that things are going to go. So that's what I'm looking for in that.
Now, the chocolate fountain. I heard you guys paid an extra buck for the chocolate fountain.
Team Ellen did.
Priorities. What are you most excited about for Mike and Gina's first year of marriage?
I'm not going to say children.
No, not yet?
No. Just that they're happy together.
Okay, fill in the blank on this. Do you think that the Pirates game will be on during the reception?
June, yes. And you know it's during the slow pitch playoffs, too. Okay. But I'll be at the wedding. And so, Char, this is what Char said. You two aren't going to play softball before that wedding, are you?
Well, you know you think the DJ will cover the score updates?
We want some Donna Summer, though, at the wedding.
Donna
Summer, David Guetta,
yeah, wanting to get going here.
David Guetta, and Calvin Harris.
Those are key, too. Mm-hmm. What do you think has changed in Gina?
She's marrying a guy. Trusting someone to move into our house and into our life and share her shoe closet with.
Give me one word to describe Gina.
Wonderful.
Oh, no, awesome. She's awesome.
One word.
Brat.
I would say caring.
You got it.
Caring.
Sarcastic. She's a great friend, and she is always there for me no matter what.
Funny.
Ooh. Sarcastic. Dedicated.
How many different nicknames do you know for her?
Do you want me to name them?
Yeah.
Stats, because she used to keep the stats for the basketball team. I know you call her Foe. G-Mall.
What's your favorite memory of Gina before you graduated high school?
Before? Daily trips to Frank's, I guess.
Your favorite memory of Gina after you graduated?
Trips to Frank's.
What do you think is her favorite part of her job?
You know what, when you see Gina with those kids, I mean, she really does have a really good way with those kids. I mean, as much as it can be stressful.
Pintar, what do you think is the most stressful part of her job?
The most stressful thing that I see is first thing in the morning, people are calling her on the phone before she even walks in the door.
How she best deals with her daily stress.
Recently, she had dealt with it by working out at the end of her day, but oftentimes I think she deals with it with an icy Coke.
You've known Gina before she dated Mike, and you've known her since she's now been engaged to Mike. What do you think has changed most about Gina?
She's more reserved. She needs a good cookbook, too.
Sarcastic and loving.
loyal and loving.
Her humor. I think she's very funny. Very sarcastic and very funny.
And your favorite quality about Gina is?
Her loyalty as a friend and her kindness to everybody. And party planning.
What is your favorite memory of Nini growing up?
Sports, or just in general?
In general.
In sports, it was winning the Whitfield at Mount Elmer.
Oh, yeah. Winning.
Do you think? And I think just there's so many favorite ones, but just watching her grow from, like, this sweet little child into this beautiful young woman.
Whenever Nini first told you she was engaged, what was your first thoughts?
Well, remember, I said they're a perfect match. They're both softball players, they're both coaches, and they're both teachers.
All right, Michael, you made it to the crush game. What I need to know is, between Gina and Mike, who do you think is the better infielder?
Well, I've never seen Mike play, so it's a hard comparison, but I'd probably say Gina.
Gina? Gina would be a good ball player if she wouldn't foul balls off to the left side all the time. Cost us probably, in all the playoff years up here at Charmin, probably about 5 or 6 dozen she's lost over.
So
the left field
instead
fence.
Of some of her gifts for her shower, she should donate them back to the league?
I would think so.
Can you remember back to 2 years ago during ESY in the initial early stages of the Flirtmance?
I certainly can. Those rousing games of basketball.
Now you were there for the early on stages. Do you remember, other than the games of basketball, do you remember any of the other parts of the let's say the chase that occurred that summer?
Oh, when you were always in our room. Yeah. You mean like the hunt?
Yeah. The hunt. Chase.
Yes. The hunt. Well, it was funny that year because we thought he came just for a visit and like to have snacks with the kids, but nope.
So he wasn't there for the kids. He was there for the one and only. Do you think he was there for the buffalo chicken dip or for Miss Mullen?
Absolutely, Miss Mullen. The buffalo chicken dip took a second fiddle.
So you saw some of the early stages of the basketball games, Mr. C versus Miss Mullen.
It was terrible because you know who won?
Wait, he's nervous for this response.
Should I be honest and tell them who won? Okay, it was Miss Mullen. I think maybe once.
You think Miss Mullen is a better basketball player than Mr. C?
Shooter.
Better shooter. He says shooter.
She is, I wish she wasn't here so I could be honest.
I'll leave it.
She is a much better shooter than Mr. C.
And I know that you have not seen Mr. C play shortstop probably.
No, never.
But you've seen Miss Mullen play shortstop.
Oh, she's amazing. So if I had to pick, my money's on Miss Mullen.
Now, who do you think would be the better shortstop? Mr. C or Miss Mullen?
Miss Mullen, absolutely.
And who is, of course, the better basketball player? That's an easy...
Well, now that he's gone, I can freely admit that it's Miss Mullen.
Oh, yes.
She has way better moves. I've seen it, I've watched it, and she has way better moves.
Okay, so now this is the first summer that Miss Mullen has not worked, and you've been in the room with him, but Mr. C is still here.
He never comes to visit. It is so sad.
So I was going to ask, I would guess that that's the biggest change. What would be the biggest change you see in him other than not visiting?
Well, he just is a little down in the dumps. He just doesn't have his spunk like he usually does. Although, we're always waiting to go out to lunch together. And we'll invite Miss Mullen when we go. So.
Oh, yeah, you're just maybe purgatory?
Maybe, yeah. Although, they've both blown me off a couple of times, so, Yeah. 2 years in a row, I believe.
Well, maybe you could take that gift card for the shower and decrease the value.
Well, I was going to get Burgatory, but I absolutely won't. I think I'm going to get Home Depot or something because, I don't like to go there, so this is something that...
That'll be like a punishment.
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not going to eat without Anderson.
If you have to think of one favorite memory of watching Gina play sports, what would it be?
Oh, I don't know. There's been so many.
Do you think your sister will continue to play softball after she gets married?
I'd say so, yeah.
Probably more.
Do you think that whenever you're your sister has kids, your nieces and nephews, she will coach the kids just like the bird coached her.
Yeah, I'd say that's a safe bet, too.
What kind of coach do you think she'll be to her children?
It should be, you know, a coach that just, you know, wants the best for kids.
Do you think she'll yell at all?
Probably a little bit.
Okay. If you take a lean half a step back, we could see Nini in the background. She has no... There okay. She is. We have no, she has no idea what we're doing. Okay. And last but not least, what kind of cake are you hoping for at the wedding?
I'm hoping for chocolate, and I'm hoping for a chocolate fountain.
Oh, I heard there's going to be a chocolate fountain. You might be in luck. Knowing Gina and knowing Mike, who do you think is a better shortstop?
Oh, my God, Mike.
Who do you think has a better jump shot?
Gina. Oh, my God, Deb. Gina. You.
Oh, Gina, absolutely. Gina. All the single ladies. Now put your hands up. Up in the club. We just broke up. I'm doing my own little thing.
To dip you. And now you want a trip. Cause another Melissa can't help but to notice you're coming out of the bathroom. Gina getting married, what's the first thing that comes to mind?
I need a pause for that. I have to think about that one for a second. First thing comes to mind, that we're going to have even a smaller glove at some point along the way with the little ones than the
ones.
Oh,
little ones,
already.
Babies on the way. You're right.
Exactly.
What do you think should be in their 5-year plan?
Triplets. I think triplets.
Do you think that Mike and Gina's kids will be more athletic than yours and Nick's kids?
Yes, they will. Of course.
Kristen Pintar, what would be the most stressful part of first year of marriage for her?
IEP season. From late March till the end of the school year, Mike better be prepared with back rubs and Coke slushes, and that should make things a little bit smoother for both of them.
Kristen, whenever she's stressful and she has to go home to a husband instead of her couch and naps, what would be your advice for her?
Just smile and put on a happy face.
We know that Gina is weak at best in the kitchen.
She's better than
us. What piece of advice do you have for Gina as she's going to have to start to feed a new husband?
Get a lot of takeout menus, microwave meals. Watch Rachel Ray.
Well, I mean, when I got married, I was not a domestic diva. And then I just really liked cooking. And so I progressed from servers? No, the hamburger helper.
Ah.
Do you think that it's ironic that it's pouring as we're talking about Gina's performance in the kitchen?
Well, rain can be good, right? Not. It's not always a bad thing. So,
what are two ideas that we should definitely have at the bachelorette party?
Something that's a competition.
No, that might be bad.
No, it could be bad.
Definitely got to have food.
Oh, yeah, definitely got to have food.
Can you do food and shoes? Does that work in the
food
same?
And shoes, yeah, food and shoes, yeah.
Can we eat out of her?
And Snapchat. How about unlimited data?
Unlimited data. That would be a good gift.
So my favorite story of Gina really involves me and the story of my CCD sex. She knows what I'm talking about, but that's her favorite story that I've ever told.
Well, I will say that Gina has subbed for the gym teacher with her class that I have been a part of, and that she is an AP gym class teacher.
She's a wannabe.
And some of the things I love best about Gina, she's the best secret keeper. You can tell her anything, and she is the vault.
I agree.
I love that about her.
She's
very understanding, always there for us. Just a great person.
What do you think, Jackie, the thing that Mike is going to have to be the most patient with about Gina?
Her shoe collection.
I was just going to say shoe collection.
Agree on shoe collection?
Yeah, well, that and the fact that she has not lived with anybody for a long time, so she's set in our ways.
Yeah.
Okay, the best quality about Gina, Brenda, is?
Gina likes to gather a lot of people together. She does. I think she's excellent at that. I love when she has her basketball girls and her softball girls with her kids at school for dances, and like she's having us all over here and she hosts the lunch. So
her gathering people. Go ahead, Deb. Mm-hmm. Best quality?
Boy, it's hard to pinpoint just one thing. I think she is an awesome teacher with the kids that she has. She loves them. She's sincere.
Marcy, best quality about Gina?
Gina is just true. Like, true in every sense of the word. You know, from her kids and her personality and herself and how she is towards us. I mean, there's nothing about Gina that's not real. She's real, and I love her.
Go ahead and describe what your favorite thing about Gina is. My favorite thing about Gina is the fact that regardless of what we're doing, regardless of we're working, we're playing softball, we're coaching together, things that are absolutely ridiculous are funny to us. Things that are stressful are funny to us. Things that are that go on always end up being funny. We have our own language, we communicate in words that people don't understand, and all the inside jokes is what I like most about my relationship with Gina.
And if you have to give Gina any advice for her marriage?
Live every day to the fullest. Be glad you're spending the rest of your life with your best friend.
Okay, so and if you guys have to give, you guys have both been married a long time. If you guys have to give Gina and Mike advice for their marriage, what would your advice be?
I would say have 5 children.
Woo!
Oh, at least 4, yeah. At least 4 or 5.
4 or 5 children. And do you think their children will be athletic?
They better be.
Do you and Lula have been married for several years? What's one piece of advice you give to Gina for her marriage?
Always do everything together.
Do you think that they should share chores together?
I think they should share everything.
Do you think she should cut the grass?
Yeah.
Do you think
and
she
I'm still waiting 40 years for that to happen, too.
The key to a successful marriage is?
Communication.
Fill in the blank whenever I ask you this. The key to a happy marriage is
cooperation. Cooperation and giving in.
Couple months here to the wedding. What's advice you could give to her?
Let Mike enjoy his golf outings with me before you guys get married. We have a couple more that we have to get in.
You have been married for several years. One piece of advice you would give to Mike and Gina would be?
Oh my gosh. Just be happy. Make each other laugh.
Laughter is the key. The key to a happy marriage is
laughter.
Laughter.
Yeah.
Okay. If you have one piece of advice for Gina in a happy marriage, what would it be?
Listen to your husband.
Key to a happy marriage is
compromise.
Okay. All right. I'm here with Kelly. She is the most recent crush member to get married. So after about a year of marriage, what advice could you give Gina and Mike for their first year of marriage?
Mike, you're always wrong, whether you think you are or not. Gina, make sure there's always food in the house. There always needs to be food. That way you can come back and say there is something there.
You know, there's a big anticipation between the shower and the wedding. What piece of advice can you give Gina between the shower and the wedding?
Don't get too stressed out. Something will go wrong, but at the end of the day, the day will still happen. Little things will go wrong, but, you know.
The key to a successful wedding day is?
Don't pass out.
You and Nick have been together for years since high school. And you have had a successful marriage. Give Mike and Gina one piece of advice for maintaining a successful marriage.
Talk to each other. All the time.
A piece of advice.
Have so much fun. Because everyone loves you, so you can look out and see everyone who cares about you and just be happy.
A key to a successful marriage would be...
Yes, dear. Saying yes, dear.
A key to a long, happy marriage would be blank.
Wow. Distance?
Yeah, when the hubby goes out of town a whole lot.
If you have one piece of advice for the bride, it would be?
Keep a good sense of humor. You'll need it.
Patty, one last tip of advice for Gina.
Never go to bed angry.
Sherry, one last word, advice for Gina.
Stay as you are. You're just as
sweet as can be.
Aw, and Nance, one last word advice for Gina.
Keep separate interests. You'll need time apart, too.
A key to success for the wedding day will be to...
drink.
Oh, the key to a successful marriage is...
compromise.
You know, I guess not arguing.
What's one piece of advice you'd like to give Gina for the for her wedding day?
Just enjoy it. It goes by so fast. Enjoy every minute. All the little things.
What is one piece of advice do you think Gina needs to know in the next 2 months to get ready for her wedding day?
You know, probably just clean eating. And hydrate. Especially on the wedding day. Mm-hmm. You don't want to feel...
Fill in the blank for me. A key to a successful marriage is?
Hot sauce.
Can you give us one piece of advice that Mike and Gina will need?
Never go to bed, man.
Don't take any guff.
Don't take any what? I'm sorry?
Don't take any guff from your husband.
You and Click have been married for a very long time. What's one piece of advice you give for Gina and Mike?
Hang in there. Through thick and thin, hang in there. Sometimes you agree on things, sometimes you disagree on things, but sometimes you just gotta suck it up and just go with it.
When in doubt, always...
doubt. Always listen to the wife.
The key to a successful marriage is...
never go to bed, Matt, at each other.
Fail going into
to marry your best friend.
Always treat each other with respect.
If you have anything to say to your Nini on the day of her wedding, what's one thing you have to say to her?
Be happy.
Gina, I got one for you. Here's a ball. Do things with it. You'll know what that means.
Cliche, but just enjoy it. It goes fast.
Enjoy every minute.
The key to a successful marriage is?
Sometimes when we're in love, we think about how we would just die for that person. You know, if a car was going to hit us, we'd push them out of the way. And little, you know, big things like that. And so I say to us, how about the little things? Like when Mike won't put his toothpaste on the toothbrush correctly, or Gina has too many t-shirts and shoes. Just let it go. Just die to it.
One piece of advice between now and her wedding.
Learn how to spell your last name.
Start cleaning out. She's gonna find room for him.
That's been happening already.
I know, she said that, but she's got to find room.
Keep being true.
Good. And one piece of advice for her actual wedding day.
Yes. Enjoy it. Yes. Every second of it.
One piece of advice for Gina when she gets married would be?
To enjoy and just take the good with the bad.
If you have one piece of advice for her wedding day, what would it be?
Just to enjoy it. Party, don't stress over the little things because they really don't mean anything.
What advice do you have for her as she's going into married life and she may have to cook for a husband and or children?
Okay, pasta salad, the famous chocolate cake, that's all she needs.
In the first year of marriage, when in doubt...
makeup.
Well, in the first year of marriage, I think it involves CCD sex.
Totally.
When in doubt, compromise.
What's one piece of advice you have for Gina on her wedding day? For your wedding day, my advice is, when in doubt, come find us, come find your bridesmaids, and we'll laugh through it together. Everything will work out. Have a good time and enjoy it. What would be one last message to Gina?
Just to enjoy life and to have some kids, because even though I said that I wasn't going to have kids, they're the best thing. So have some children also.
My interviews today bring me to the Shaler Area ESY program. This is the one and only place where Gina and Mike started their flirtmance, started the early stages of their dating. So I came to interview the infamous ESY phys ed teacher, the always Shaler wearing groom here, the groom to be. And I have a few questions for you, Mike. First of all, we want to know how well you know Gina. What's Gina's middle name?
Marie.
What is her birthday?
August 21st, 1981.
Gina's favorite restaurant?
Wings, Sides, and Spuds.
What is Gina's favorite part of her job?
Working with the people she works with and working with the kids.
What is Gina's favorite women's NBA player? Who is?
Schuyler Davis.
Where has Gina's favorite vacation been?
San Francisco.
If Gina had one thing to do on a day off, what would she do?
Probably sleep in, then go out to lunch with me, or dinner with me, and then probably take a nap actually after that.
What's our best recipe, I should say?
Her chocolate cake.
The world famous chocolate cake. Okay, so Gina has been a homeowner for some time now. You're going to be moving into her house with her. What do you think is going to be the biggest challenge?
Fitting all of our stuff into one house. All of our clothes and our shoes. And her giving up some of her space.
What do you think is going to be the best part about starting your marriage together?
The best part is just being able to be with each other on a regular basis and having fun together. We have a lot of fun together and just spending as much time as possible with each other.
Gina's best quality is?
She has a huge heart and she's always wants to help people and, wants what's best for people and she always has a good time. She always has a smile.
What do you think will be the easiest part about fitting in with the Mullen family?
The easiest part is talking sports with the bird. No problem. That's easy.
Now, I know you don't have brothers from your family, but you're going to be gaining a brother, ironically, with the same name. What are you looking forward to most in gaining a brother in Mikey?
Well, hopefully some financial advice. He seems like a very good financial guy. I wish I could help him with his golf game because I can't probably be the one to help him. But it's funny because my brother-in-law, I have two brother-in-laws, and I will have two brother-in-laws, and they're both named Mike, and my name is Mike, so it's actually kind of funny.
Gina's worst habit is?
Leaving stuff out in the kitchen.
What do you think is Gina's favorite thing to do as being part of the Shaler School District?
Probably coaching and working different sporting events. I think that's a side of teaching me both.
Mike, you work a lot of sporting events and coach too. Do you think that you guys will work more sporting events, less sporting events, or the same amount of sporting events?
I think for now it'll be the same.
You guys have not booked a honeymoon yet. Your honeymoon will be to?
Hopefully Hawaii.
Last year at ESY, Miss Mullen's classroom was right next door to my classroom. True or false, you spent a lot of time in that classroom?
Well, last year I spent a lot. I think it was the year before.
The year before, I agree.
Last year was probably more awkward than anything else because we were actually dating and it was a little bit different. But the year before when it was the
flirt
the
man.
The chase. Was a lot of fun.
What was the excuse that you used to spend in the room?
Well, I like to eat, and they always had a lot of food in there and snacks, and then we team taught together for phys ed, so we spent that period together.
Who scheduled that?
That was the nice maid of honor.
Okay.
She did a nice job with that. I always
scheduling.
Asked her to do that.
I should probably get a thank you note from that. Do you think that the aides in the room, the ladies in the room, knew that you were on the chase?
I think they did. I think they were on to me. So know how much I like the food, though, too.
Do you think that they were in support of that, or do you think that they were chasing you out of the room because you were eating them out of classroom?
They were in support of the of the chase, but I think I always offered to bring stuff in, but they always said no. I think they were getting a little sick of me eating all the food.
Mike, speaking of bringing in food, what's your favorite recipe?
Pepperoni bread. It's very good.
And how often do you cook for Gina?
I tried spaghetti one time, but she was late from a softball game, so it was cold, so that didn't work out too well. That would be the only time. I tried chicken one time on the grill, which my mom kind of threw me under the bus on that one. Bought the wrong chicken and took about 3 hours, I think, to make grilled chicken.
What would be your favorite kind of date with Gina?
Go down to the dinner down at the North Shore somewhere, and then go to a pirate game. That would be mine.
If you had to buy Gina one gift, what would it be?
Well, I already did. I think she was more excited about that when she got the ring, but a pair of shoes.
The ladies here at the shower know the story behind the engagement. How long was the engagement in a plan before it went into motion?
Probably a couple of months, trying to wait for the shoes to come in and just try to come up with a good plan because I knew I couldn't be in two places at once and needed some help, but it was for a couple of months. But it wasn't a hard plan. It was just waiting for stuff
to fall into place.
Yeah.
And on a scale of 1 to 10, how nervous were you to talk to the bird?
I was more nervous, I think, probably talking to Mr. Mullen, but the bird was okay. We didn't even get to it for most of lunch, and then I thought I was going to get through all of lunch and not even be able to talk about it. I was like, there's no way I'm coming back and doing this again. So finally at the end, I got it out, and you know, because we were just, of course, talking about sports prior to that, and then we finally got it out.
So maybe, like, our nerves were, like, 5 or 6?
It was getting worse as we went, actually. It started out pretty good, and then it was getting worse, and it was the cafeteria was getting more and more crowded, so that was making it.
And then on a scale 1 to 10, what were your nerves like with asking Minnie?
Probably about 9.
If your mom had to say her favorite thing about Gina, it would be?
Just how sweet she is and how much, how she knows how happy I am because of her. And just how much fun we have together. She knows how good Gina's been for me and hopefully likewise.
Okay, and I'm going to put you on the spot with one last question. This will be your last one. We're sweating out here. We're still on the Shaler Area track, the home of the ESY program, where all the romance started and began. One last question. This will be the very end of the video. I want to know what message you have for Gina on the day of her shower.
On the day of your shower. My advice to her, for sure, is to just enjoy it. You only get to do it once, and you know, don't be nervous. Everybody's there because they care about you, and they want you to, they're excited for you, and they want you to have a great time there, and as you prepare for the big day. So just have as much fun as you can and really enjoy it.
Now that we don't have to spend the next hour and a half opening up a ton of gifts of silverware and sheets from Bed Bath & Beyond, go ahead, enjoy your time, mingle with your friends, get to talk to the bride, and enjoy yourself. Thanks for coming.